Okay, now we're gonna block our swatches. So I have let them soak for at least 15 minutes, and then I just rolled them up in a towel to get out any excess water so they're not dripping wet, they're just very damp. So we have our swatches here. We have our first swatch, which was the placed beads and lace. And then we have our second swatch, which was a couple of different bead techniques. And we had the rogue traveling bead that I'm gonna fix when I block this one. The first thing you want is something to block on. I use Knit Picks blocking mats, and I like those a lot. And then you need some pins. You need rust-proof pins, not rust-resistant pins. Rust-resistant pins rust. I know that from experience. So make sure you have some rust-proof pins. And these ones I think are, I don't know, Oritz? Probably can't even read that. And I just got these at Michael's. So just make sure that they are rust-proof. And you just want to lay out your swatch. And for this, we were just practicing beading techniques, so we're not worried about dimensions or shape or anything like that. Well, we'd like it to be square because it was a square swatch. So I'm just going to start out by kind of stretching it this way and that to kind of get the stitches to open up a little bit more. And then I'll pin it down. And this swatch should be fairly square if your gauge was similar to mine. So I'm just going to start and pin a corner. And then kind of stretch it out to where I wanted it. And I'll pin the other corner. And then I'll stretch it down this way, pin that corner. And this way and pin that corner. And again, this is a swatch, so you can just kind of eyeball it, but if you were doing something that you really wanted shaped a certain way, you should get a hard ruler to use and make sure that your lines are straight. And now that I've stretched it out like that, I'm just gonna make these edges meet up with the other ones. And if you want to, like I said, you can get a straighter edge to use to do that against so that you're sure it's straight. Then once you get it pinned out, you can just mush it around a little bit, straighten some things out if the pins are pulling, and flatten it out. And now I would just go around my initial corners and kind of pull that in a little bit because that's really sticking out far and that's not going to look very nice when it dries. So I'll flatten that one out. And that looks better. And that's it. And again, this is just a swatch, so we just want it to dry out nicely so we can see the lace. It's not a garment or anything I'm gonna do anything in particular with, so I'm just doing this quickly for this tutorial. So now on the second swatch, I'm gonna also fix that bead there. So again, I'm just gonna stretch it out a little bit, flatten everything, pin my edges. And for the bind off edge, you want that to sit a little flat, so you want to go in it this way and flatten out those bind off stitches. I'm going to pull this one up a little bit to meet that. Same over here. Now that's pretty straight, and then get the sides over here. There we go. And I would not pin in the yarn that's holding these beads, because you'd really drag it out. If that's the effect you want, that's fine. You can really pull these out and pin them, but for this swatch, I'm just gonna pin the stitches in between. Alright, and then we still have our rogue stitch to deal with, so I might have to undo some of these pins so I can get to it. What I'm going to do is I'm going to grab a crochet hook so that I have something to manipulate the bead with and fix it that way. So here I have a fairly small crochet hook, but it's suitable for this yarn. And this bead floated up and over, so it should have been on the leg of the stitch, and what happened was it went up and over onto like the head of the stitch. So what I'm going to do is right here is where it should be. It should be on this leg right here. So I'm going to pull up that leg and then try and pop it through. This is the leg above. So there's my bead. I'm just going to pop it right through. And that's how you can fix them. It's easier when it's flat like this. So all I did was I lifted up the leg of the stitch above, because that's where it had slipped through onto the head. I lifted up the leg of the stitch above, and then I pushed the bead back onto the stitch it was supposed to be on. So now we have blocked our swatches. And what I usually do when I block, I do what I just showed you. I do it fairly quickly. This one looks pretty good. This one, I would probably go back again and keep straightening out these edges and re-pinning until it was really nice and square. So I'm probably going to do that after I stop recording, so that when we have a whole video to watch, I have a nice, beautifully blocked swatch to show you. And that's that.